Hello, everyone and anyone, to my YouTube content ID nightmare. I mean, let's play Fallout 4. Long story short, people might have seen it. I got a content ID dispute for the music that was being offered on the classical station. I had made the mistake of thinking, oh, well, it's been licensed by the game. That plus is classical music. I'm pretty sure all those people are dead now, not realizing that music companies still hold the rights to some sonata that was on the classical station. So anyway, that's why we're getting this without any sound. I've tried re-recording the footage a few times, ran into some problems, so wanted to make sure you guys could see what was going on. So the subtitles are on, and it's going to be me giving commentary to it. What's happening? This isn't happening. That is Ziyal, what the idiot savant. This is basically talking to Codsworth about what's going on here. You probably have seen this footage itself in, like the promotional materials or whatever. But I like to think that this way you get to see it again. But this is about the sixth time I've seen it. In terms of talking to Bloody Codsworth. So yeah, I might be distracting when I'm talking about the Let's Play here, but just letting you know the trials and tribulations that went through, plus I'll be honest with you, Codsworth really just gives you the advice to go down the block after some adventures you have with him. But I figured it'd give me some time to set things up before we have a beautiful montage towards the end of dealing with something you'll see. Ooh, surprises, right? I think it's gonna be in the name of the video, honestly. But yeah, so YouTube content ID dispute. I was like, whoa, I'll just get a guitar and I'll play my own music. That's how I'll screw them over. No, it's one of those things where you can't win, and you just have to take it like a man and whine about it over post commentary on your video. That's about all you can do. I've gone a little insane doing this. The way that it kind of worked out is that last night, getting Fallout 4, it gets released. I'm so excited. I get the first video out. I quit after the first 40 minutes of gameplay to make sure that I can upload it to people as soon as possible. Now, part of that's being a small channel, you know, with my lovely 46 subscribers, and it's the reason why I'm doing what I'm doing here. To make sure I have something out there to connect parts to the content that I've already done that is fine and not going to get matched for content ID. So I take the first part of the video and I roll it out as soon as possible. So I take a 40-50 minute break for everything to go through, encoding process and all that good sort of jazz. And when it finally gets on through, you know, I'm like, all right, finally I can play again. And then I run into the issue of before any content ID nonsense, of I basically play the game, but then I run into a problem to where I'm using quick saves instead of saving the game manually. So what happens is that when I have a recording failure, which is really happening because I use Shadowplay for my recording software, right? And Shadowplay for video recording, that is. The auto recording I use Audition CC, that's what I'm currently using to talk to you guys here. But the idea is that you can't really use their audio codec within Shadowplay because it's kind of trash. It doesn't sound right. That plus, okay, we got gameplay volume being too loud and people talking. You have to find that right mix of things. And honestly, Audition makes my voice sound, you know, like it's how it's supposed to sound, I think. Everyone sounds different in a recording, right? But the idea is that so pretty much all the whole setup of getting everything together is putting all this together the way that it is. But when I had parts 2 and 3, the original parts 2 and 3, I had to replay an hour's worth of game footage. And mind you, this is at 4 o'clock in the morning, right? 4 o'clock in the morning, I have to redo an hour's worth of game footage to get myself back up to the big bad fight that I was at, because I didn't have any bloody footage of it because the recording software didn't go. Sometimes it just seems like if I'm not paying attention, there's that little status monitor for Shadowplay telling you it's recording video footage, but sometimes it just decides, nope, we've had enough. It might be a background process. I'm sure it's my fault. I mean, let's not delude ourselves here, or I shouldn't delude myself. it is definitely not my fault. But you see this? You see this conversation with Cosworth? Yeah, I've recorded this and I've watched it. I listened to it about 5 times already. I picked different options. It doesn't really matter. He really says the same things after a while. So anyway, that is the joy of YouTube content ID disputes. And to that end, I also wanted to get back and actually talking about Fallout 4, because that's what people are here to see the channel. And I'm just going to flat out say it. I do not mind a single soul in the universe. Hey, you know, watch this with the audio. If you're not able to play the game, watch this as it should be from anybody. I'm not going to be offended, because I'd like to listen to it with sound. But I simply, at my 5th time trying to record through it again and finding out that the recording mysteriously stopped, or it never had started recording even though I saw the indicator, I decided that, you know what, it's time to try something different. And I figured out that later on doing a montage, and I'm actually doing some editing to clear things up, will be a much more enjoyable experience, especially the amount of times that I die to nonsense, because I'm playing on very hard, which I think is actually not even as hard as survival difficulty. Take that, Blowfies. Boom, boom, boom. I gotta tell you, Cosworth does the majority of the work here. I'm missing left and right. But really, it's a matter of Fallout 4 is an amazing game that I'd really like to play, but the idea is that, you know, I'd like to play and like to show what I'm doing and what I'm trying to do with this idiot savant build. I will tell you one thing so far. I just kind of have very middling stats all around, pretty much fours and everything, minus intelligence and then the 5 in luck, I think it is. And, oh, here's me breaking a lock. Bobby pins. Oh, do I still have that old black magic? Yeah, I do. I'm just happy whenever I do that. That's just one of those things that's all muscle memory. You just remember, don't break the bobby pin. You only have one of them. I really want to play Fallout 4, and that's what I did today. You know, when I got the email about content ID disputes, was after I'd already recorded parts what would have been 4 and 5, but that is pretty much a moot now, because both of them had the content ID disputes for the classical music being played. One of them was like you could do revenue sharing, right? And that could have gone to you know, share revenue for the video by, you know, these big conglomerations that own, I think one of them was VPN Music. So I, you know, share revenue for it. And hey, I'm fine with that. But what I wasn't, I'm fine with that, and I would have just rolled with that. But one of them was the fact that I think Columbia was just like, no, you can't do this. And because of that, somehow it's a Colombian company, or at least it says Columbia, or Columbia was a music company, excuse me. I was thinking it was this freaking country. This is how tired and insane I've gotten, right? They're like, no, you can't use this, and it has been barred in the U.S. It's not viewable in the U.S. And I'm like, well, who would be interested in seeing game based in Boston, you know, Massachusetts, post-apocalypse? Oh yeah, maybe people in the U.S.A. might be more interested than more so than others. So obviously cutting out the United States and probably the majority of my subscribers. I haven't actually found out if anyone's from anywhere other than the U.S. I kind of have to say I'm assuming somebody'd have to be. It's just law of averages. That was our first little cut there. And yeah, there was a shopping cart. And that's the mistake. Do you see right there? Classical radio. Putting it on. That is the mistake that cost me dearly. Sanity. All that is gone. All thanks to classical radio on there. Now, that is 100% my mistake, and I should have been smarter than this. And it's something that, honestly, I only did because it was late night, I'm excited about playing the game, and you're just kind of, you're into it. And that's kind of how it was rolling. You'll see me crossing this bridge here. We're on our way to Concord, because that's where Cosworth told us to go. And we find some dead guys here. Uh-oh. In traditional RPG fashion, they become naked bodies pretty quickly. That's just the way that it goes. I think I equip some various things here and there. And what's important to note is that everything here is going to match up to the parts that I've already done with the same talents, specs. Even though I had to replay this particular section of the game, I've replayed 4 times now, I think it is. It's like something obscene just because of the mistake late nights and the mistakes, whatever. So it's a matter of, you know, this is the solution I thought most appropriate, to ramble at you for the entirety of this video and occasionally strum the guitar when I get nervous. But pretty much we're heading down the road to Concord, and on the way there is the Red Rocket gas station, and we'll meet ourselves our old friend here. I think that they've done a pretty good job with Dog Meat so far. Okay, I might have said that just a little too soon before he showed up, but hey, that's post-com for you. But Dog Meat, he's here, and he is glorious. They do a good job of him being the command, and he actually helps out quite a bit in combat, sometimes by just being something else for them to hit. And he can't be killed. That's a big plus. That'll come very, very much in handy later as Dog Meat epically tries to go up against something that he really shouldn't. I'm actually surprised at how quickly they throw something crazy at you in the game. If I had a... this is Dog Meat, basically. We shoot commands, and I'm just playing around with it a little bit. But it's a matter of, you know, oh, pick up this. Oh, Dog Meat will occasionally find something. And when he finds something, you have to wander around the hole wherever he is. And Dog Meat, just like any dog, will start barking at something, and then he'll just be like, yeah, I'm good. I'm over here now. What? What do you want? I'm over here now. And it's a little random with the AI. It's not terrible. It just can be a little distracting, can I say. Here I am picking up parts to a mechanical horse, I believe. Because everything in this game can be broken down into scrap parts, right? So I'm just like, yeah, pick up whatever I see. And that's kind of how it rolls. And I think with we're just kind of looting this building, me and Dog Meat. Oh, what's this now? Battle has been joined. Let's see how useful Dog Meat is. And this is my probably the first real battle other than those blowflies from the beginning, and experiencing what it's like with the new vats. Vats is pretty awesome this time around. I like that it slows things down rather than a full game stop. It's, you know, bullet time, and, you know, yeah, been there since Max Payne 1. But at the same time, it keeps the action going a lot better than the previous Fallout games, I feel. That, and it's just pretty exciting, I gotta say. That's one of the things that they're doing a great job of, is that actually I'm surprised it feels a lot more first person shooter focus than it was before, because really you're much more you're better off suited if you aim with your iron sights than you try to take a shot in vats at certain times. Now granted, that's my skill set at the moment. This is what I found out with my 4 agility or whatever it is for guns. Oh yeah, this is where I teach Dog Meat. Oh, you can hold on to things, huh? Well, here you go. Help out your habit, buddy. And I give him a carton of cigarettes. And that's, you shouldn't do that to a dog, okay? I'd like to point that out right now. That is not cool, okay? But, you know, your companion's going to hold on to things, so that's what you got to do. But anyway, this is where I get stuck in the, oh, cool, I can make things here function for a minute or two. Before we find this, oh, what? Ah! One of them will sit here, and nope, I've been crippled, so I've lost some use of my limbs. See, I like the little animations that pop up now. You see, they did a lot of good little animations and little touches that really bring you know, Vault Boy to life. And there you go, finally, Mole Rat down. This is where, oh, a little bit of searching around. Whenever you're doing this, always want to search around for these computers, even if you have a 1 intelligence. A lot of them are unlocked, and I see something. Ooh, what's this going on here? Okay, I believe I actually take the time to read out this entire thing, which just being used to from the other Let's Play. I don't know if I'm gonna be doing that in the future because it could be a lot. But I see, oh, safe storage, you say, and this is letting me know that there is basically underneath somewhere is a safe, and that's all I need to hear. Safe, and then basically right around the corner, you'll see we're able to go down here into the den, if you will. I'm picking up everything I can see. Dog Meat's ready to go. He's good to go. And we try to go with a little bit of stealth action. I'm trying not to abuse always hiding before attacking, but I gotta tell you, it's so very useful to get that 2x damage multiplier. That plus, I just, it's hard to get away from what I normally would do, I suppose, in Fallout game, which is always having some sneak and trying to pull off these shots, because, I mean, there you go, one shot, done. Now, granted, I think it's only, I mean, on a very hard, I think it's like two shots and they're down. I think I have a happy accident here, which works out pretty, does that work? Yep, happy accident. I shot the fuel tank behind it. It's like, what? And then just firing madly. It's like, yeah, all right, yeah, I meant to do that. Woo! And yeah, pretty much exploring the rest of this little den here. And I'm pretty sure I walk into some radiation waters. And I'm being very diligent about trying to pick up everything, although I definitely miss, oh, what's this? Fusion core. Well, that seems important. Going here before you go to Concord can give you a very small advantage, I suppose, in the sense that you're going to be tasked to finding a fusion core eventually. But it's kind of just something that'll be better for the future, I suppose, because that is how... Oh, this is the boss. Just like the end of all the Skyrim dungeons, you have the one big bad. It's like, that's a rabid mole rat. That's higher level. You have the last big bad mole rat that you got here. And there's the safe. And I give myself my bobby pin action. Twist and turn. Oh, that was easy. And there you go. Is it worth it to come down here? Yeah, totally. Because getting the fusion core is good for the stuff that you'll see. Pretty much at this point, considering this is post-commentary, it's funny that I'm trying not to spoil later parts of this video, because that's going to be coming up pretty soon. But, pretty soon. The thing is that I feel like there's a lot of cool stuff going on here in Fallout 4. Mainly, those radio stations will screw me. They do a good job. You can't fast travel when you're indoors. I was just checking that out, even though it's technically outdoors. I've noticed they've done a lot of this, a lot of like areas that are being cordoned off by a small loading screen. Now, the loading screen isn't too bad. I mean, really, if you think about that, I have a decent computer, an i7-4770, I think it is. And it's loaded on the SSD hard drive. The SSD is a couple years old, although I'm not really quite sure if there is a massive increase in solid-state drives at this point. But it loads up pretty quick, so it's not too bad. It's not too bad at all to get everything loaded up. I have no idea what it's going to be like for people on PlayStation 4 and Xbone. I imagine it can't be that bad, but I just think back to the horror stories of... the horror of watching a Bloodborne Let's Play without the things taken out. Oh, this is my very first level up, an idiot savant. The whole reason I did this, I saw this and I said, okay, we got some luck, let's use it. So I toss an idiot savant. The idea behind this is that if there were sound here, and you'll hear it in later episodes, anytime you take any action, you have an opportunity to gain XP from it. Normally, your XP growth is determined by your intelligence. Kind of how intelligence would tell you how many skill points you would get in Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas. And, well, every Fallout, I suppose, before this one. Now it's kind of like, oh, you just get your experience a little bit faster this way. So taking Idiot Savant is a way of having a low intelligence character that is able to get things done. Now, here's the thing I'm going to say so far. I have my character voice lines. I'm asking questions to people in the idea of role-playing. I don't know what's going on. What's going on? I don't know. But I haven't yet to find a single you have low intelligence interaction in the game. Now, it's early, you know. I'm where I'm actually at in the game, I'm about 3 hours in, maybe. Oh, check this out. Isn't this great? This is one of the reasons why... How could I re-record this footage? Look at this. That is beautiful. That is majestic. It soar like an eagle. I mean, my God. What can you do about that there? I can't recreate that. I mean, that's one of the reasons why I wanted to use this footage. But it's like, nope, can't do it because you got the classical station on. But here, we're pretty much being yelled at to pick up the musket laser and help defend us against these here Raiders, yo. And, you know, the Raiders are a better football team this year, but for the most part, they still suck in Fallout. But since this is harder, I do believe that I run into some issues. Some of the stuff that I do appreciate what they do is I do believe that they're more prone to tossing out explosives on the harder difficulties. So it's not just a straight bump in... it's a slight AI change as opposed to just nothing but an increase to health, which is really annoying when they do that. Here's me attempting to hit long range this guy with terrible chance in VATS. I don't know what I was thinking. And I'm like, what can I fire? Oh, hand crank. Yeah, that's right. Saw this in the video. So having to deal with this hand crank gun. It's neat. I think they have a lot of cool, the laser musket, they call it. They have got a lot of cool ideas. When you're coming through this area, everything's coming to life and a little bit of anti-British propaganda for Boston, I suppose, for Revolutionary War, as you're coming along here. And you're just minding your own business. And then you're just like, oh, what's going on here? And I just shoot a guy in the back. Safest way, isn't it, right? And, yeah, take care of him. Oh, miss. Those crosshairs are super wide. And but see, look at Dogmeat. Dogmeat just takes care of business. He just does not mess around. Which is really cool to see. Because a lot of times, I mean, I'm thinking back to Fallout 3. See, I gotta tell you, I get confused with New Vegas all the time. But your companions really... Dogmeat really feels pretty strong. I enjoy that. Because, you know, it makes you feel like you're not so alone here in the waste. And there's opportunities to look through all the stuff here. Though, bear in mind, there's people crying out for help, and people are like, I'll make this quick, I'll kill you, I'll murder you, but I still find the time to loot, because that's what you're supposed to do. No, really, I tried to, like, oh yeah, I should have a little bit more sense of urgency instead of just hanging around and taking my time and such, and kind of come up here. And I mean, just look at the size of these reticles, though. When it comes to most of the time. There we go. Got her. Oh, she's still not down. And there you go. Dog meat. I mean, doesn't that just looks glorious, doesn't it? Yeah, I know. A lot of sorry. Feeling the void of speech. But I find that dog meat takes out things. This laser musk is pretty cool. Here we have a precarious situation. Are they showcasing explosive barrels? Really? Like, what part of the exhibit was that? And I believe I knock him down, but look who decided to... I don't think it actually was a grenade, even though it showed a grenade icon. It just was an explosion because he shot the damn fuel tank. So, there's a cut here. And this is where the... soon the cuts will come fast and furious. But, there's where I forget how to attack for a while. Started trying to melee. There we go. Take him out. You see your crit build, or your crit meter is building at each time you get a hit in VATS. And that's part of what's going to hopefully make the luck run interesting, is hopefully just getting a whole slew of crits. Because the crits can be kind of glorious. I mean, look, that guy's melted. Hey, come at me. Boom. And another shot. Now, I'm always going for these torso shots because they're the easiest to make. I definitely try to go for headshots and more interesting things later, but the cool thing is that you can't just pause time the second like a melee guy is right on you. I think you'll see me try, and I'll definitely take some damage because of it, because it just slows down time, and you're still getting hit while you're in VATS. And I don't think you have the massive DR bonus that you did when it was in like Fallout. I'm not sure on that though. Try to shoot him through the door. Yeah, I got him. That was lucky. A couple shots in a row. Yep, open up the fridge. That's most important. Oh, there we go. Yep, bash him. Bash him back. And I'm like, oh crap, I hate this gun. He's attacking me with a pool cue. I hit him. And then I think I actually timed that so where I got a counter on it, I believe. I don't know. Or it just looked like that. It looked really awesome. And this is the first time, the game is brand new and I'm so excited to be here. That's where I try for some headshots. Whoops. Whoops. Just, you guys ain't moving. Just, it's one of those times, just go there and shoot him. Shoot her. Shoot her. Please don't Constantine me Jurassic Park. That was Idiot Savant right there. You hear a little jingle, and Idiot Savant just gave me some bonus XP for taking any action. And there you go. And the option is to go talk to the people. Like, come in here. We're in trouble. And, of course, I take the option of let's go explore and take everything that's here. Of course. But I think that there's a lot of cool stuff going on here. This is where the game kind of railroads you a little bit, but it's not bad. It's interesting, at least. You meet your first big old NPC pact, if you will. And this gentleman, Preston Garvey, and he's a Minuteman. And Minutemen are protecting these people because they're some of the good people left in the wasteland from what I've seen so far. For all I know, they're going to end up having a George Washington's brain. Oh, or they already do that in Fallout 3. Anyway, but the idea is that pretty much defending against raiders here. And he's got a really cool hat. I mean, I was just saying the thing that was a Muldoon. What was the guy's name in Jurassic Park? He's got that Aussie cowboy hat. Good thing going on there. I don't know why the flap needs to be up like that. Seems like it would make it so the sun would get in your eyes on the right hand side. But hey, what do I know? I'm not a Australian cowboy. Or whatever kind of hat that is. I don't know. I think it's really just because it's more old fashioned to the British colonial times. Of course, I would think it would be on both sides. Pardon me for a drink because I'm rambling. Oh yeah, total mistake. But talking here, and you see that, you know, they do some nice little interactions. You'll see me sometimes moving the camera around because you can actually, while they're talking, you can move your head about. They actually made this cinematic here. It's not just talk to NPC and you get the whole dead eye stare as you zoom in like real close up on their face. So, you know, moving the camera around, seeing what I can do. It's limited, although I think you can actually just back out of conversations too. You'll see me accidentally do that once or twice. Where you just back up and you're like, you're still in the conversation, but you don't have to stand there the whole time doing the whole cinematic thing. So, I mean, there's a lot of little improvements to the engine, although I think this engine is probably the same one they've been using since Morrowind. It just keeps getting updated and updated and updated. But if so, they're pulling a lot of things through it. From Elder Scrolls 3 to 4 to Skyrim to Fallout 3 to finally Fallout 4. But I mean, they're making a lot of things work. I think that the motion cap for the characters now, you definitely notice a little bit more emotion in their faces when they're talking. Maybe not Sideburn Sturgis here, but I think I've noticed it on my own character's face. And that's actually kind of the big thing, is that the whole talking thing, Mass Effect dialogue style, where your character has a voice, and whether or not that works for Fallout, I can't say quite yet. I kind of feel like it's one of those things that's tough, because I feel like they kind of railroad you down this plot to come down here this way to go take care of stuff, to where I think I probably could have gone in a different direction, but they start you in like the top left corner of the map. So you're kind of just stuck doing this, finding yourself going through the Minutemen and Concord and this area. Trust me, I played through a few times and I keep going down that path because that's what that's what's recommended, or that's what's right in front of you. But I'm not so sure if it's the right choice for Fallout, because you do kind of it's the right choice for Fallout in its base game before mods. Yeah, probably. It's definitely accessible. This is where I decide to pick up the another crucial luck skill, which is going to be Mysterious Stranger. Eventually I move over to it. Yep, and I'm like, yeah, do I want to take that? No. I do not want to take that. I'm pretty much just looking over all the skills and deciding, like, nah, we're just going to stick in luck for a little while. Because I do think that the new skill tree and the way they're trying to level you up with perks instead is interesting, and I think that there's a lot of cool stuff that can be done with it. I can imagine this whole thing being redesigned mod style to reinvent the whole game by the way they level you up. And it's different than just like the fact is that if you feel the freedom instead of like Skyrim, oh, okay, I have to only use axes, or I have to only use this or that, or two-handers versus one-handers to gain that skill. I could use a laser rifle. I just may not be that great at it. And I can also be using melee right now. I'm actually finding that the rifle butts, I'm able to finish off enemies with them sometimes, and it feels, you know, pretty satisfying being able to do that. And you're not able to, you don't have to be pigeonholed immediately into your build. Although, as I'm finding out with because I choose to play these games in very hard, I'm probably going to be choosing a style of attack to do, and we'll have to see which one that's going to be. I don't think it's going to be laser muskets, though, because to get these things leveled up or properly modded, you need to get intelligence to get the proper mods going for it. And no thank you. She loves chems. She wants stuff here. And this is where all of a sudden I notice something, or maybe soon. I'm just like, oh, these guys don't have anything to say to me. But what's that? Wow. I mean, that's not even trying to hide. I mean, they're just like, yep, here's a perception bobblehead. Boom, there you go. So don't start off with 10 perception, anybody. You're all set right there. You'll get it right then. Plus, you're wearing glasses, and there you go. Which I always start out games wearing glasses until I find the right helmet combo or whatever works for me. And here comes the whole... I think that I imagine on normal this is probably a lot more turret section, if you will. But the way they were talking about is the fact that I already got that fusion core is that, hey, there's some power armor. Power armor, you say? And go power armor and go get that minigun and go shoot up some bad guys. And it's like in my head I was thinking, oh no, are they turret sectioning me already? But it's not bad. It's actually quite engaging how they do things. And the fact that the one thing I found out that because I was treating it like a turret section the first time I played through this. Yep, this is the radio. Screw me yet again. Every time I look at it, I just get so frustrated because I made a stupid mistake. There's me popping in the fusion core. And then, boom, just like you're wearing some mech suit from... well, pretty much any anime ever, or most of them, you pop yourself in there and go, all right, let's get in here. And then, boom, you are part of the power armor, which is a cool mechanic. I think they did an interesting job of it. And there's a lot of customization, although you notice that some of the... I had a hard time reading this at the first. I'm like, what the heck is going on here? Your health is in the bottom left. Your rads are right next to your health. Your what armor piece is falling apart next is above that. Got your map as usual, and you got your core, basically how much power you have left in the power armor. And from what I can tell so far, I think it gets removed by movement and in general and action points, because I'm looking at it right now. And I'm not seeing it go down too fast, but yeah, you can just jump down. You don't take fall damage in this, which is really cool. Yep, yeah, shoot through a telephone pole. But don't shoot the good guy. Yep, there you go. Back to Gristle. Gristle takes a lot of... I mean, come on, that's a lot of minigun shots. So when I said before, you know, this guy is... Oh, idiot savant. These guys just get their health increased. Well, they do get their health increased. But they're a little bit smarter about some of the things. I don't know. I'm not 100% sold on it, but I think I have to look at survival difficulty versus very hard. It might even be harder, but you'll see with these wonderful... That's me executing a critical attack. Idiot Savant going, yeah! There's some more XP for you. And swinging away. And you'll... Basically, you're like, okay, yeah, turret section, kill raiders. Everything's good. And then you look around and realize that there's only a couple of them left. It's like, all right, I'm close. Don't hit Preston. There you go. You try to step on dog me. That's what you get. And take this out here. And then, okay, there seems to be some stuff popping up. And then you're like, wait, what? I'm attacking over here. I haven't even actually seen it myself. You know, this is 2-3 o'clock in the morning. Mysterious stranger, first appearance. Boom, takes out the raider. And I'm like, all right, I'm feeling invincible. And then I look around and I go, what? Oh my gods. Yeah, that's right. They pulled it out this early. It's like Fallout New Vegas trying to head straight to New Vegas. There's a Deathclaw. There it is. And you notice this is a minigun, and I'm pumping damage. I'm pumping bullets into this bad guy here, Deathclaw. And I'm like, no, don't worry about those guys. Just shoot the thing in front of you. And I'm shooting him in the belly. Look at that. Yeah, check it out. Those were two VATS hits with the minigun and all the damage that they did. You'll see, I have a lot of different attempts in how I attempt to do this. This is just me going, oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god. And you'll see my HP is down to very low, but I couldn't even tell what my HP was unless I was in VATS because I didn't know what the timer was. And bam, the second death of the LP happens. And this is where I'm going, there's a target here somewhere. Oh no. He's in melee. He's on me. Shoot something. Just shoot him. Shoot the guy. I miss. They're gonna hit. And then they love to do this too. They have a little bit of the scripted sequences where it's like, yeah, he pushes you down and he lets you know that you've been bad and you are not gonna get your supper, young man. Takes care of this, and I'm just pouring bullets and I'm like, oh crap, can't back up any further. Down I go. Attempts number 3 on the Deathclaw. At this point, you'll notice his health is lower. That's because I have already... That was a shotgun critical to the head, by the way. How much damage that did. I did not have minigun bullets at this point. I thinking it's a turret section for a video game. They're just going to give me infinite bullets and whim bam bam. Yeah, I was wrong. And then comes this whole bargaining statement. Excuse me for my chair squeaks there. This whole bargaining that comes down to, oh god, can I take him out with this crappy shotgun? I think even at this point, I had misused my laser musket hits, and they were pretty much gone. Find sanctuary in the church. Ah, we shall convene with God. And you see, I mean, he's getting close, and I'm feeling like it might happen. This is me going back out after I've collected my wits. I'm like, come on, just die already. There goes a whole bunch of my health. He's bad breath face again. And I'm just like, no, must live. My health is down to like 5%. Church, sanctuary, peacetime, out of action points, can no longer run. Dog meat. There I go. Down again. This is my attempt of five? And look how close he is. And I'm just like, okay, nail him in the head. I don't have a critical. I'm missing some of these shots. Crap, there's most of my health, and down I go. So they're definitely not screwing up the damage on this guy. And the power armor, yeah, that was just like straight up Raptor from Jurassic Park. And this is my explanation the first time around to where I lost my footage because of using quick saves. And that is the Unicorn of Technical Difficulties. Found that on a New York food website, of all places. But I kind of love that graphic. Anyway, so this guy must die. So this is me coming back and being a little bit more frugal. This is after having replayed that section again. And you should hear the commentary. I know I sound a little insane now, especially because you've been listening to me. If you actually have listened to this point, you are a saint. At this point, I've been pretty much going for about 40 plus minutes. Oh, boom. There you go. That felt good. There comes the Deathclaw, comes on out. But I was sounding so insane at this point. It was great. And I was getting a bad habit of, normally I don't have a problem talking while I play games, but at this point it was like, nope, time to shut up and focus. So I'm still talking during this, and I'm trying my best to get this guy down. And it's going better, because there we go, got a critical shot there. did some more damage. I mean, these Deathclaws are just insane. I mean, the skull next to his name, or next to him, would indicate to me that he's too high level for you to take out. But they really want you to take him out because this is your power armor tutorial section. And this is me cheesing it in the church. And then look what they do, though. Instead of just having him stand out there because he can't enter that building, which really he should be able to enter that building, they make it so that, oh, try to throw a grenade. Okay, that grenade totally missed. And I'm firing. Oh, that's okay. See, I've like instinctively know my way back into the church in safety. And back again. Deathclaw goes over there again and hides away. So they made it so you can't just 100% cheese it. And I'm noticing for a second, it's like, what the hell? There's still guys alive here? And they actually hit the Deathclaw, and I'm so amazed by this that it really throws me for a loop, and I'm trying my best to run away. I'm on fire, and down I go. And at this point, I had a little graphic saying, like, okay, this is where I get serious. Super serious, y'all. The explosions. Everything is happening. It's just me and the Deathclaw, and this is, at this point, this is the second time recording. It must be close to 5 a.m. probably, after the game had come out. And I'm trying. I'm just like, must complete this. Want to have footage to show people tomorrow, which is working out really great today, let me tell you. And here we go. Just shooting away. It's going well. It's going well. Feeling all right. I triggered the Deathclaw early this time around. And looks like the car did not do that much damage to him, if it did damage at all. But I am abusing the minigun, and I'm using a short controlled burst best I can. Yep, there goes that critical. I think I tried shooting him in the leg this time around, because the idea is if I could slow him down, then maybe he's not actually going to be able to catch me, because you're not exactly swift when it comes to your power armor. And I think it actually works. The leg, I think, might get crippled because he's not able to catch up to me nearly so fast. Look at that overheating gun. Oh god, Sanctuary Church. And here I'm thinking, I cannot keep doing this. It's 5 a.m. I'm tired. I'm over and done with. And just want this to work out okay. So it's just like, alright, let's see what we got here. Fragmentation, grenade, trying everything I got. And he's reset here, but I've noticed, wait a second, there's raiders left alive? It's like, hello. He likes to throw dirt, cheap son of a gun. Yep, keep nailing him, hit him with everything you got. Oh, that's the bad hit. That's the one where I think, oh, another try goes down the drain. But I find my way back to the church. But this time, he's got himself some friends to play with, which helps me out a little bit. And I'm turning around, and your dog is in trouble. That's what happens to Dog Me when he gets in there. I'm just like, let's not waste our action points on shooting him in the tail. And if you keep him in this main street, you'll get some help from Preston, I believe his name was, Musket Man. And I'm just wailing away. And then, got to get back to church for safety, for a reload and all this. And you'll see the bullet counter is in the bottom right. And it's just so close. It's so close. It's gonna happen. And the suit's doing a lot better. I'm feeling like I might get this done this time. And I throw a grenade, and this one actually hits, I think. It's hard to say. This guy's DR is insane. That's me taking all my frustrations out in Fire Hydrant. Shoot the head. Shoot her. Come on. Used that joke already like twice. Fire. So close. And I think the best thing about this is there it goes, 36 XP. Yippee. I didn't even realize he's dead. I'm just so used to running away. And when he covered up the church door, I was like, what? And then I realized he's dead. And I'm not sure, but I think that raider got the final hit. Or one of these raiders got the final hit. And once he's down, idiot savant. There you go. And once he's down, he is down. Pick up the hand, pick up everything you need. Because life is good. You've earned your free pass of life. And this is my opportunity. You can get dog meat up with a stim pack. Or just kind of wait and you'll get him back. He'll just pop up. But I don't know what his health is like. So yeah. Nearing the end of this long rambling section. All that's left is taking care of these remaining raiders. Which after the Deathclaw, I mean dog meat can finish this encounter at this point. But yeah, it's super hard, and I think they did a good job. And I hope you guys enjoyed the montage that's going on here. And one thing, I'm not going to be, there definitely will be no ads for this video because I can't justify putting ads for the video. I don't care. I mean, yeah, it took a lot of heart, sweat, soul, and everything to do this, but there's no audio. You can't hear what they're saying, and I'm talking over it the entire time. This is me just trying to make sure people get footage, and if they're interested in hearing my story of content ID woe, then this is it, basically. But Fallout 4, worth checking out. The LP is going to continue. I'm going to continue. Regardless of being bad at recording games, playing games, I'm still going to keep going. So if you do enjoy this, which I'm, yeah, you will be amazing if you do, please consider leaving a like, because that'd be awesome. And help out, especially because of my recent struggles I've been having. And subscribe for more, where there is audio but no classical music, because classical music is the devil. Brings out the worst in everybody. So thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Take care, y'all.